Hi there, Dr. Kim here. I've got some exciting news for you. For those of you who've been following me on social media, you know that over the last month, I've been pretty busy, right? I've been quiet in terms of my online presence. I haven't been out there doing training. Why? Because I've been back here in San Diego and I've been doing some research and testing of a brand new drone. This is a new mapping drone that I've been waiting for a long time. Recently, DJI has come out with a new line of mapping Mavic 3 Enterprise drones. Enterprise means that it is a commercial or a mapping professional level type of drone, all right? This isn't your recreational, off-the-shelf commercial type of drone. This is made for more hardcore work. So today, I'm going to go over sort of some of my tests and give you my take. What do I think? Do I like this drone? Do I not? Actually, I'm in love. I can't even pretend like I can hold it off to the end. I'm going to let you know right now, I absolutely love this drone. I think that this is going to be a game changer for those of you that are out here and you've been just using a Phantom or using regular drones, RGB drones, which for environmental managers have decent accuracy. They can do about 95% of the things that my stakeholders need them to do. But this new drone, the Mavic 3 Enterprise Multispec, to me is a game changer. I just wrote a list really quickly of the top 10 reasons why I think I absolutely have a new girlfriend. And I'm in love. So over the last 30 days, let's give you a backstory here. I am a professional drone mapper. I'm also a drone instructor, and I'm a marine biologist who uses drones and geospatial web mapping technologies to map our world, our environment, and use it to make more informed decisions about how to deal with some of the problems and manage some of the issues and solutions that we are looking to find as environmental managers. That being said, I have a few drones. I became a commercial pilot back in 2016. I started flying drones in 2015. So I have a little bit of experience. And so this is the new mapping drone that is out there. And I was lucky enough to be given this drone, the demo unit, by my favorite drone store in the United States, or anywhere, I could say the world, I guess, which is Drones Made Easy. And they're based here in San Diego, California. Previously to this drone, as an environmental manager, marine biologist, I've been just using RGB drones, and I've trained hundreds of people and dozens of organizations around the Caribbean and California how to use drone technology for all different types of industries and applications related to the environment. And for 95% of those applications, just an RGB off-the-shelf drone like your Air 2S or the Phantom 4 Pro, Mavic 2 Pro, those were great drones, all right? The accuracy was plus or minus a meter, which was pretty darn good, especially when you're mapping a mangrove or a reef, all right? You don't really need that centimeter level. So there's always with drones, you have to find a balance between the data you need and how much it costs, right? So I'm always testing and trying to understand that fine line. So that's, of course, what I did with this drone. This is called an RTK module. This allows the drone to get not plus or minus a meter accuracy or a half meter. This allows the drone to be survey grade centimeter level accuracy. So this comes standard with the drone. Check. That's pretty cool, right? The next is the spatial resolution of this drone. So this has got an amazing camera on it, all right? It's got a 4/3 CMOS sensor with a 20 megapixel RGB camera. It also has a mechanical shutter. So when you hear this thing flying and taking pictures, it's like 0.7 of a second capture rate. Why is that good for mapping? Because it reduces that motion blur. It has absolutely shocked me at the speed that it can map up to 15 meters per second while it is shooting pictures at 0.7 second intervals. This drone is a beast. Okay, so that is amazing. The fact that you are not just collecting the RGB, you can simultaneously collect multispectral imagery. So if you notice up on the top, right in there, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 more bands or cameras. All right. There's a red. So multispectral looks at different spectrums of light. So we've got the red band. We've got a red edge. We've got a green band. Sorry, I was going to say blue, but it's green. And we have the infrared. So those all have different applications and uses. Primarily, this drone is made for agriculture. But those multispectral bands are also very important, not just for plant health. You could also look at water quality. You can look at algae in the water. We can penetrate, I'm hoping. I haven't tested this on reefs. I'm doing that in the next few weeks. But penetrating down through the water column and being able to map the reefs and the seagrasses and the other water or the other habitats that are maybe in the shallow coastal waters, which I have successfully been able to do up to a kilometer offshore using a regular RGB. But with this multi-spec, it's going to be a whole, especially that red edge band. I'm really excited to getting out and digging into researching that. So the fact that it is shooting all of that at the same time, simultaneously, is awesome, right? Why? So that when you're comparing data, because some things you can see in the visible spectrum, other things are more apparent using other spectrums of light. But the fact that you can shoot at the same time, which means they're exactly can be lined up point for point, tit for tat, as well as you can view on your screen with this RC, you can view everything side by side. You can record everything side by side. So you can look at both cameras at the same time while you're flying and shooting. So there's one huge benefit there. The other thing that I love is that standard with this drone, besides getting all of the cameras and the RTK, you get this. You get this Pro RC. This thing is, especially, I've been working in the Caribbean and we're out in the sun. And one of, when I'm training teams to fly, one of our site checklist things is finding shade. For those of you that have done my boot camp, finding shade, because the glare is so bad. You can't see what you're doing. You can't see the tablet. Even with the hood, it's like a nightmare. Okay, this baby, I can be out in the blazing sun and you can still see. It's not overheating. It's not freezing the way your iPad freezes. This thing is amazing. And the other thing is it's an Android device, okay? So you can plug it in. It's got an SD card slot. You can add data. You can do screen records with this and record what's happening on your screen, as well as capturing the data with your drone. So huge benefit there. Next thing, why do I love this drone? Besides having the multispectral, it's got something on the back of it, a sunlight sensor. So this sunlight sensor is really cool. I've been testing flying this drone at all times of the day, the night, like right up to sunset to see and mapping with it and processing the data and seeing how well it handles. And I actually mapped yesterday evening at sunset and it was pretty close to dark. And those pictures were phenomenal. That map and the sunlight sensor, when I upload and process that data, you wouldn't even know I flew at sunset. So I talked to Nell about all the spectral things I think that I love. The next thing that is pretty darn cool about this is that it's got this RTK module on it. So the RTK, for those of you that are surveyors, you know what an RTK is. For those of you who are not, why the RTK is important is when you're looking at changes over time. Let's say you're looking at erosion on a beach, or you're looking at some sort of other factor, like I'm mapping across the street from my parents' house right now for a neighborhood group. They are redeveloping a golf course and they've dug down in the water table. And so every day I've been mapping the same area. And so we want to see the changes over time and we centimeter level accuracy to be able to snap each map and bang on to each other, the exact same place, is extremely important when you're looking at site changes over time. So this drone has an RTK. So you're like, cool. The other huge benefit besides it having the RTK, traditionally, surveyors know you have to have a differential. It's called a GNSS station, but it's a base station that actually corrects for the drones and the atmospheric and the magnetic anomalies that are happening in our atmosphere. So that, again, a lot of information, I know. But it's pretty cool because you can do all of the above with this. Let's say you don't have access to any of the above. You don't have cell data, so you can't get into that local network. Guess what? There's still hope for you. This drone has something else, which is amazing. It's called real-time terrain aware. So it doesn't just have the downward sensors, like we all traditionally know, these obstacle avoidance sensors, right? That tell the drone, oh, you're 10 meters or 100 meters off the ground. All right, it has those, okay? But it also has a radar in this drone that is radaring down to detect the ground. So it is using both sensors to be able to detect the terrain when you can be 100% offline. So this is happening in air, real time, no data, and the drone's using its own sensors to hold you on a steady amount of AGL or above ground level. So the other huge benefit of this drone is traditionally there was a lot of problems, and even where I'm sitting right now, this area here has had for me historically a lot of electromagnetic interference. You're in a city, or maybe you're by power, you're doing inspections around power stations, power lines, other areas with metal, you might have a lot of interference. And in the past, that causes flyaways, it makes your drone go crazy. Trust me, you've all been there. Those of you, when you do my boot camps, I take you to those sites and we fly near them on purpose so that you can understand what's going on and how to get out of that situation. I think with this drone, though, so far, I haven't had any electromagnetic, and I've been pushing it. As those of you that know me, I test it. I've been going out there looking for cell towers, looking for metal, looking for really hard areas to fly, and I have not had a problem. I have been able to take this drone again. So the other thing it's got, it's called APAS 5.0. That is called like Advanced Pilot Aviation Systems. So on top of the fact that it's got a great signal, when you hit return to home on this baby, it doesn't matter if you are 10 meters from your home point, 100 meters, 50, or 2 kilometers. This drone, if you have the APAS enabled, will find the quickest, most efficient way for the drone to fly home using its obstacle sensors and go around objects. It does not necessarily have to go up to the traditional height, turn, and then fly and then go down. So they've learned, or they've built this, that it can now basically use the most efficient route and speed and direction to get back to you as quickly as possible. I think we're coming down to the end of my list. What else do I love? You can live stream your drone's feed real time via YouTube. Yeah. You want to see it? Stay tuned. I'll do it in the next week. I'll do it in the next few days. Okay. So that's pretty cool. As long as you've got data, you can live stream your entire flight to anybody while the drone is in the air. And I've tested this even in areas where I knew I didn't have much data strength, and I've been surprised actually how well it's handled it. And then number 10, reason why this drone is so cool, especially when I've been testing and learning and experimenting, is that when you're doing a mapping mission, mid-air, you can not just pause the mission and start the mission. You can pause the mission. You can open it up. You could edit the mission. You can save it and reload it while the drone is just hovering there. Yeah. So you are able to line up. You can also switch missions mid-air. You can line up multiple missions. So long story short, this is the best drone I've ever used for mapping because of the size, the speed, the safety, accuracy, and the fact that I'm able to get all of the spectral resolution and bands all simultaneously with a screen I can see and having no interference for the last month flying over 60 different batteries on this drone. So I've got lots more to share, and I will be releasing a class. I'm filming it right now on everything you need to know about the Mavic 3 Multispec. So I'm going to go under the hood on this drone. I'm going to talk a lot more about these functions, and I'm also going to do a really deep dive into the Pilot 2 flight planning app and all the settings of this drone, because there is a lot. So if you want help and you want guidance, I'm here to help. And I would love to share with you all the lessons I've learned in the last month with this, but in the last 7-8 years of me drone mapping and flying. So thanks. I hope that this was very informative and you are inspired to come fly with me. All right. Thanks.